Well, this is your guys' first time in here, huh?
It is.
So we're still working on it, but it's an amazing building, and we're excited about it. But on to this week, we started really our Texas A&M prep in earnest this morning, and this is a little bit of a bonus day for us. So although we worked on them a little bit last week, this was the day when we really started to present everything to our players, and our guys are in good spirits. We're relatively healthy considering where we are in camp. We talked about Kenny Lacy being out, but besides that, and then the other guys that are known, the Deshaun Holliday or Alex Akinbulu, we're in pretty good shape health-wise, especially the guys that, you know, we figure will contribute as part of the depth on Saturdays and Sundays this year. Heck of a challenge this week with A&M. Some unknowns, you know, they've got three quarterbacks that they're really not divulging who's going to be the starter. All three are a little bit different in style, so that'll cause us to, you know, have to have a plan for each of them. Not sure if they'll stick with one the whole game or rotate them through or what they'll do, but, you know, we can't control that. All we control is our preparation, and our guys will be ready for that. You know, defensively, they're aggressive. We know the scheme. They lost a couple of really good players, but they just reloaded with some tremendous players as well. Their two defensive tackles are very disruptive. Their free safety is all ACC. We know Priest Willis, their right corner, pretty well. They start, it looks like on their depth, they'll start a true freshman at one of the linebacker spots. But it's going to be a great game. We went out to the Rose Bowl on Sunday and did a mock game. You know, we have a new locker room, we have a new side of the field that we're on, new uniforms, four new guys on our staff that are new. So we went through really up to halftime and then out for the second series of the second half of a mock game, and it was really important for us to do that. I think it'll help us going into the game Saturday. I know that for me, I was turning left when I was supposed to be turning right in the locker room. You know, everything's just kind of reversed. It's the same locker room, just set up differently. So I think everyone will be very comfortable on Saturday. It should be a great environment. It's going to be a beautiful day, and hopefully we get a great crowd out there. And I'm excited to watch our team play. You know, we've worked hard. These guys, since really leaders on this team, our LAC guys, have really taken hold of the culture, and we're in a good spot right now. But I think, you know, every team in America is probably able to say the same thing. We're in a good spot right now, unless those that, you know, played last week and lost. So it's going to be fun. It's going to be exciting. It's going to be a great game. They're an AC or a SEC opponent. They are a heck of a team. They're very well coached, obviously, on both sides of the ball with veteran quarterbacks. And Kevin has been at it a long time. But we're looking forward to the challenge.
I know you have at least one guy with Houston ties. Is everybody okay there as far as family?
Yeah, two specific, Will Lockett and Najee, both from the Houston area, and both of their families are safe and sound. I think they were a little distracted for a couple days because there was some uncertainty, but talked to both of them this morning, and they are good. Their families are fine, and they're focused, and they feel comfortable with things. But certainly our prayers go out to everybody in that area that's suffering, and you know, I wouldn't announce it now, but I'm thinking that our athletic department will be doing something at the game just to be able to raise some funds to help those people in need down there.
Does that add another layer to the game because they're dealing with this, Texas A&M?
You know, I don't know how much it's affecting them where they are. I haven't checked into that. I'm sure that if it is, it's tough. I'm sure that you know, they have a lot of kids that are from the Houston area whose families are affected. But I also know this about Kevin. Kevin he's a heck of a good guy. He's got a great empathy, and I think that, you know, if anyone can manage that situation, it's Kevin. And I think by the time they get out here on Sunday to play, hopefully things are a little bit back in order there. There's a plan. People are more comfortable and safe and secure, and that their players really can play their best and play uninhibited. They deserve that after all the work that they've done, just like our guys do.
Would you say 2 years removed from having Nolan Mazzone here, does it still help that your scheme, the scheme against him, or know his tendencies?
Yes and no. It's you know, when someone asks you that, you can always say, yeah, we got a pretty good feel for his tendencies, but he's got a pretty good feel for ours, and he knows we've got a pretty good feel for his, so he's going to change them. This game, is always one of unpredictability, the first game of the year, because, you know, you've had your spring, your summer workouts, your training camp to prepare for this game, where in the regular season you've got 3 days to prepare for a game. So you just never know what you're going to see. And Noel's creative. He's always been very creative. And, you know, we'll see how it unfolds. I think the most important thing, Tracy, is that anytime you go into a game like this is that, and it goes back to what Coach Wooden said, and what he always did, is that, you know, you focus on yourself and your fundamentals and your techniques and your calls and your rules. And if you do that, then you can usually get through anything that you haven't seen before.
I know you're close with Noel. You guys talk leading up to this, or talk during the summer?
We talk during the summer quite often, a lot of time by text, but we do stay close. He is a good friend of mine. He's a great man, and he did tremendous things around here. I think sometimes he gets a little bit of a bad rap here, but if you look at the offensive numbers that he put up here, I think a lot of the records, if not all of the records, you know, were under his watch as a coordinator. He's very talented. But this week we don't really communicate. You know, as good of friends as we are, you know, I want to kick his tail and he wants to kick mine. And then after the game, we'll you know, give each other a handshake and a hug and wish each other luck the rest of the way. But there will be no good lucks before the game.
How much of a challenge does Christian Kirk pose on multiple levels, just because he, you know, returns kicks and obviously receiver?
Yeah, the guy's a legitimate Heisman Trophy candidate in my mind. We recruited him hard, so we know him very, very well. He's extremely talented. He's got speed, quickness, he's elusive. You know, they use him as a returner. Obviously, they put him in the slot. Sometimes they'll put him out on away from trips on the single side. They'll use him in the backfield at times. You just never know what you're going to get. One thing you know you're going to get for sure from him is just a very great competitor. You know, I remember going to one of his games at Saguaro and stand on the sidelines, and I think he scored 3 touchdowns in the first quarter, and they were all just like special type of runs, like, okay, he's tackled. Oh, no, he's not. Touchdown. No one touched him. You know, he's a special talent, and he's a real challenge, and you have to account for him. You know, if you don't account for him, you make a terrible mistake.
Jim, obviously, Miles Garrett, Deshaun Holland, both gone. What have you seen from that front seven, Texas A&M?
Well, you know, we haven't seen a lot because all we really have to go off of is the spring game. But we know that 2 defensive tackles are very disruptive. We know that, you know, the coordinator likes to get after the passer. You know, they're a good pass rush team. And so, you know, we're anticipating that they'll be pinning their ears back and coming after us off the edge. And we just got to be able to do a good job of protection. We've got to be able to run the ball so that they can't just pin their ears back and come after us in obvious passing situations.
Do you have a starting punter right now?
Stephen Flintoff is our starting punter right now, but Austin Kent will be ready to go. I think that through the spring and through the fall, Stephen has proven himself to be very consistent. He's worked very hard. Our players have confidence in him, and we're going to go with him.
No decisions on scholarships yet? Still waiting?
You know, I'm waiting. Right now, we only have one to give. You know, things can happen in the next few weeks. We really don't have to make a decision until school starts. We're fortunate in that respect. You know, there's certainly some guys that are very deserving, and you brought that up because of Stephen, and, you know, you think of Christian Pabico because he's going to be involved in the game plan, and there are some others. So, you know, we'll just have to make the best decision when we have all the information, and I would like to be able to reward any of them that I think deserve it. You know, it meant a lot to me when I was, you know, given a scholarship. I know what it feels like. I know what it means, there's always guys that kind of come out of the woodwork, and you really wish you could reward them. Usually we can, but this might be a tough year.
As a former walk-on, any special words for Christian Pabico coming into a game where he hasn't played yet and he's going to be on a pretty big stage?
You know, I think that he's played on special teams in some of our games, I believe. Don't hold me to that, but I believe he has. I don't get the feeling from Christian that the stage would be overwhelming to him. You know, he's a pretty confident kid. He played at Long Beach Poly. He played in some good games. And it's different, obviously, you know, playing in the Rose Bowl compared to playing in high school. But he was a productive guy. His teammates have great trust in him. He's worked hard. He's been consistent. I think he's going to be okay. You know, I'm not going to say anything to him. You know, if he asks me a question, I will. I'll just, you know, encourage him to go out there and do his best. But I've surely been impressed with him.
Thank you.
Is that it? All right, I'll see you guys.